And from shoe bomber Richard Reed to a blind sheik who wanted to blow up New York landmarks, there are precedents for the upcoming civilian trial of alleged 9/11 plotters. There's growing controversy over the Obama administration's decision to put the self-proclaimed 9/11 mastermind and four other alleged plotters on trial in New York City. The proceedings may be spectacular, but this case certainly won't be the first of its kind. Let's bring in our Homeland Security correspondent Jean Meserve. She's working the story for us. Jean, you've got some good comparisons here.
I think so. You know, the question has been, will the trial of Khalid Sheikh Mohammed and the four other alleged 9/11 conspirators be unlike any other? The answer we found is both yes and no.
There has never been a terror attack in the U.S. with the scale and horror of 9/11. And there has never been a trial of an al-Qaeda member as important as Khalid Sheikh Mohammed. But terror trials in civilian courts are nothing new. The people responsible for the first World Trade Center bombing and the bombings of U.S. embassies in Kenya and Tanzania, Sheikh Omar Abdel Rahman, the so-called blind sheikh who wanted to blow up New York landmarks, shoe bomber Richard Reed, who attempted to bring down a transatlantic airliner, and 9/11 conspirator Zakaria Moussaoui have all been tried and convicted in federal courts, some of them in New York.
I'm quite confident that we can safely hold people there, that we can protect the people who surround the courthouse area and bring these cases successfully.
The 9/11 case will differ from others in one important respect. Mohammed was waterboarded 183 times, and that will complicate the prosecution.
Applications will be made by the defendants, for example, not to use any sort of statements or evidence that were the product of any sort of coercion or misconduct.
A defense attorney in the Moussaoui case predicts there will be, as in his case, serious issues of language and culture to overcome and mountains of evidence to explore.
There were 180,000 FBI interviews. There were hundreds of videos that we had, and there were thousands of CDs, and there were a couple of thousand images on every CD.
Classified evidence has played a part in all the terror cases, but only lawyers, not defendants, have access to it, and it's discussed only behind closed doors. The blind sheikh and Moussaoui both use the courtroom as a platform to espouse their jihadi beliefs. No one would be surprised if Khalid Sheikh Mohammed does the same thing.
Defense attorneys and prosecutors say this trial is likely to be similar to other terror trials in another respect. Because of its complexities, it will take years to get underway and more years to try it.
Wolf. Wow, that's a long years and years. So we're talking not just a six-week trial or anything. This is going to go on for a long time.
That's right, because they expect there to be so many challenges from the defense to evidence and the like.